Oleh 81 Pagi, Pak. Apa kabar, Bapak? Prof. Prof. Setia, apa kabar? Good morning, Prof. How are you, Prof? How are you, Prof? Morning. Can you hear my voice, Prof? Can you hear me, Prof? Pagi, Pak. Suara saya terdengar, Pak? Suara saya ada, Pak. Can you hear my voice, Pak? Can you hear me, Pak? Okay, sorry, sorry. There is audio troubles. Pak Yasir, how are you, Pak Yasir? You are better, Prof, ya? Alhamdulillah, ya. Yeah. I'm worried about it last time ago. Yeah. I'm sorry for being late. I'm really sorry. In my home, Pak Yasir. Yeah, at home. Because in the office, many people, you know, many people. And then I command my all family to go out first. All my children and my wife also. Yeah. Yeah, it should be. To make me more confident, Pak. Salah, Pak. Yeah, okay, Pak. I'm trying my best. Selamat pagi, Prof. Ada very ya, very clear, Prof. Didi. Ya. Ya, better, Pak. Clearer. Selamat pagi, Prof. Sehat selalu, Prof. Didi. Selamat pagi, Bu Lucy. Siap, Bu. Mohon bimbingannya, Bu. Iya, Bu, insya Allah, Bu. Pagi, Prof. Bahren. Sehat, Pak. Iya, ya, Pak. Ya. Trendingnya makin melonjak, ya. Update-nya, ya. Baca berita juga. Ya, Pak. Ya. Ya, thank you, Prof. Thank you, Prof. Amin. Thank you. Yeah, insyaallah I'm fit already. Oke, Pak. Oke. Oke. Oke, Prof. Oke, Prof. Oke, Prof. Oke, Prof. Oke. Oh, wait, wait. I am activating my WhatsApp first. Okay, okay. Wait. I'm off my WhatsApp. Clear, Prof. Okay. Okay, thank you, Prof. Okay, I would like to present my PPT. Can I share now? Please enable me to screen share, Prof. Sorry. Make me as host or co-host. Okay. Is my screen visible, Prof? Okay. Okay, I will make it PowerPoint presentation. This one? This one, Prof? Okay, wait, wait a minute. Okay. Okay, wait a minute. Actually, I have made it in glass format, but still like this one. Okay. Okay, wait a minute, I'd like to make it more visible. Okay. Is it clear? Okay. Yeah, I have it. Actually, it is full, but in my screen. Okay. Oke, assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. The honorable chairman of examination, Prof. Stiono, and then the honorable external examiner, Prof. Didi Soeherdi, and then Dr. Luciana M.Ed, And then my promoter, Professor Dr. Barnumal Siregar, and then Pak Yasir Yasenir PhD, and then also the administrator for this my proposal defense. First of all, I would like to say thank you very much for the time, and then I hope in this session I can present my draft proposal in a smooth way, in understandable explanation or draft. Okay, the honorable examiner, I am Rudy Haryono. At this time, I would like to present my proposal entitled The Representation of Intercultural Pragmatic Components. It is a case study of three Indonesian senior high school EPL textbooks. And then for me, analyzing EFL textbook is very something challenging, because during my reading experience, my preliminary observation in reading about the EFL textbooks, I have some background or motivation. Why do I choose EFL textbooks? As we know that textbooks plays a role very important in the process of learning and teaching of English. But however, actually there is still controversy or pros and cons on the use of EFL textbooks. And then in my opinion, there is a mismatch of English curriculum. I mean that with a curriculum 2013 or the curriculum 2013, with intercultural communicative competence in global English issues. I have a short or brief analysis of English curriculum, Kurtilas 2013, that the main goals of Kurtilas or curriculum 2013 is about competence. But in my opinion, there is still a misconnection with intercultural pragmatic. And then the curriculum or the English or EFL still grammar-based content, and then genre-based, descriptive, narrative, and then recon, and so on. But the social function, it has a lack of explorations. And then furthermore, the EFL textbook still not authentic and has no contextual instructions. And then, so I do hope that in my proposal draft here, I can evaluate or make an evaluation of English textbook from Indonesia. And then there is also improper selected speech act with the level of age of learning. Yeah, as we know that actually senior high school students, they should face a wider and global communication. But in the syllabus or curriculum, the context only students, teacher, and peer with the same age. There is no explanation about a wider communication with a foreigner or what with having a different cultural background. And then in Indonesia, there is still rare about evolution of EFL textbooks. As you know that actually there are so many publishers in Indonesia that they issue English textbook, but the evaluation or the analysis or the study, the research is very still rare, especially in the context of intercultural pragmatic components. And then problem also is the consideration for selecting EFL textbook still on based on the publisher aspect, yeah. So the teacher or the school only considers the publisher, maybe because of the publisher is popular or reputable, but without seeing the content or the intrinsic components of the textbook. And then why intercultural pragmatics? Because I have read about a little bit about pragmalinguistic and socio-pragmatic aspect. The most important things for teachers or the writer of textbook, they can put or express how what to say and how to say it in more a social context. And this is very challenging, yeah, in Indonesian context, because the same speech act will have a different style. In the Indonesian greeting will not be the same as maybe American greeting, yeah, and then Indonesian promising or saying goodbye will have a different context or expression with intercultural components. And then the conversation and speech act that meets global communication framework. This is also the challenge. In my opinion, many textbooks still in global context, I'm sorry, in local context, and then the content sometimes is not appropriate. The culture content sometimes is not appropriate. Actually, in Indonesian context, maybe it should be in local context, but sometimes the story or maybe the narrative comes from another culture. And then the last but not least is distribution of speech that suits to the level of communications. As you know that learning a language from the beginning until the adult or more advanced level, it's a step. Yeah, in children era, there is indexing and then memorizing. But in wider communication for global or adult learners, they should be able to communicate wider communication in global context, because they will go further, maybe for their academic career or maybe for their their job. And then the weakness of textbooks, I have read some literature here that failure of textbook is inefficient. And then there is social and cultural understandardized, and then monotonous strategies in speech act, and then the lack of pragmatic information. Sometimes the task or the assignment for the learners, the books only has a very short instruction, not in more contextual instruction. And then I'm moving my slide. Yeah. Okay, I'm moving my slide. Okay. Okay, wait a minute. Okay, wait. Maybe it is. Okay, this one. Okay. Okay, the weakness of the Apple textbooks, as you can see here, that textbook fails to what? To have efficient learning, and then the source of pragmatic information is inaccurate, and then the inadequate understanding of the contents of the textbook from social and cultural aspects. And then Selsa Mursia and Thur in 1995 says that language function separation from contextual and stylistic variables. In my teaching experience, I see that many tasks or assignment from the books or instruction, it is very strict and doesn't consider social factor and really textual. And then, of course, the final stage or the final phase for someone who learn English is they should be able to communicate in global communication. And then this requires not only linguistic, but sociolinguistic and pragmatic competence. And then this is intercultural competence components according to Sikhi 2018. that there are three aspects that should be mastered by learners: knowledge, skills, and attitudes. And then, so my current proposal is, I would like to propose a new model in English textbooks. I do hope that I can make a maximum achievement in my dissertation, that I can present a new model of English textbook using intercultural approach. And then, of course, I will make more analysis to English curriculum, maybe based on the Speech Act or English conversation that contains in EFL textbooks. This is my research question. I have two research questions. How are the intercultural pragmatist components represented in Indonesian National High School EFL textbook? And then, to what extent do intercultural pragmatist components of Indonesian Senior High School EFL textbook meet the global English status? So these issues is very important for me, and then I do hope that I can meet or answer these two research questions, and then make something new. It is about the approach of intercultural pragmatics in EFL textbook in my, as my final product. And then this is my research objective, to investigate the intercultural pragmatics components, and then to investigate whether the three EFL textbook meet the global status. I mean, do the three EFL textbook represent global textbook or only for local context? And then this is my contribution and my novelty. Of course, this is very challenging for me. I hope I should be able to provide a more appropriate Indonesian EFL textbook from a pragmatic competence view, and then the product for my proposal. And then I hope that my dissertation also can be an alternative and paradigms in Indonesian EFL textbook, because curriculum 2013 in my opinion is still not focused on intercultural pragmatics, and still focus on genre base and grammar base. And this is my limitation. So I would, as my unit of analysis, I will analyze or evaluate three Indonesian EFL textbook: A Pathway to English and English for 11 from different publisher. Okay, and then my literature review. This is Dear Examiner, you can see here. It is short explanation or description about English curriculum. Actually, Kemendikbud has goal that curriculum 2013 is designed to face the 21st century learning model. We can see here it emphasizes on mastery of vocabularies, genres, and social function. And the interlocutor context of communication is peer and teachers. So there is no pragmatic issues here, only social functions. But social functions, once again, for me, is very limited context, only between peer and teacher. There is no more wider communication, for example, with a global community, well, or maybe with a global perspective. There is, in the table, we can see there are 9 social functions in Bahasa. I do not need to read this one because of the time. So the summary of social function, that the communication is only between peer and teachers. And then also Harling and Taylor explained that there is imbalance inclusion of pragmatics and grammar in curriculum. And then for the solution later on, I will present an instrument how to assess about intercultural competence maybe does the EFL textbook meet the global status, or is it only for local use? And then this is the objective of foreign language education as my literature review. So there is culture learning objective, and then language learning and general skill. And as an EFL textbook, actually the ideal one is they should consider about this one, not only grammar aspect. And then what is intercultural pragmatic? This is intercultural pragmatic is still what? Still something new. In my opinion, maybe it is developing in one decade. Yeah, in one decade. And there are many books actually discussing about intercultural pragmatics. And then I do hope for my what for my correction or revision in the next step or session, I will have more insight about intercultural pragmatics. So intercultural pragmatics is a language system is to put use in social encounters between human beings who have different first language, communicate common language, and usually represent different culture. So EFL textbook really has these challenges. How Indonesian EFL textbook, they can present EFL textbook that is not only for Indonesian context, but it relate with global communication. And then Klopek 2008, that an English learners, they should have a competence, sociolinguistic competence, pragmatic competence, sociocultural and intercultural awareness. And then how to be communicative in communication, yeah. Kennel and Swain, they argue that there are four framework for communicative competence: grammatical competence, sociolinguistic discourse, and strategic competence. And then in intercultural communication, I got this one from Selsey Murcia. It is about the chronological or development of communicative competence. That intercultural competence, dear examiner, it requires or it focuses in three aspects: strategic, sociocultural, and actional competence. So I do hope that during my exploration of the EFL textbook, I can make or I can highlight this aspect: strategic, sociocultural, and actional competence that will refer to a biggest issue. It is intercultural competence, pragmatic competence. And then senior high school students, of course, they need more contextual and global communication of EFL textbook. Okay, this one still have the same focus with previous slide. This one also, this is a component external competence. So I will highlight and checklist and then analyze the speech act that proposes by Selsey Murcia. Because in EFL textbook, of course, there are many kinds of conversation and speech act for the content. So I will make some kind like a cross check. Are the English speech is suitable with this framework or not? Or maybe in EFL textbook, greeting in junior high school, there is greeting. In senior high school, there is greeting, but what is the difference? Is it still how are you? Is still discussing about how do you do and so on, without any fillers from a local context. Okay, and then this is as my literature review, and then relevant previous studies. Actually, there are many relevant studies. There is survey and then descriptive analysis and then content analysis. And then textbook evaluation, socio-pragmatics, yeah, Inawati, Nazi. But for me, what makes different is my draft proposal I will also relate with English curriculum. So not only about the EFL textbooks. And then this is the global competence in communication. Why I put these issues? Because of course we should know in wider context, maybe in Asia and international context, what happening now with English global, that also still trending for now. And then this is global English, Crystal, that of course global English, he said that a language achieves a genuine global status when it develops a special role that is recognized in every country. And then the final goal, of course, for English learners, they should be a global graduate. It means that they can convey or express their expression not only in, but they can hinder or avoid pragmatic failure in communication. Because pragmatic failure in communication will often one's personality. But making error in grammar or in structure, it will be said as not a personal thing. But when there is a pragmatic failure, sometimes it is often did for a different culture. And then there is this theoretical framework for research question one: how are the intercultural pragmatics? I will answer by using five analysis framework. You can see here pragmatic information, contextual variable, and code, communicative language teaching, observation scheme by Gundus. Yeah. And then the research question two: to what extent do intercultural pragmatic components of Indonesian standard high school textbook meet the global English status? I will answer this question by presenting the concept of five senses proposed by Smith in communication and by Rehm's concept in intercultural communicative competence. And then how do I select the textbook? I will weigh the textbook and then narrow down and judge the quantitative and qualitative. And this is my unit analysis. There are three EFL textbooks. And then this is qualitative research with content analysis. And then data source will be speech act and selected conversation. And then for data collection procedures, I will read the three EFL textbooks, identify and highlight speech act and conversation, and compile the speech act by using, as mentioned, five analysis from different expert or previous study. And then for data collection, on the second question about whether intercultural pragmatics components of Indonesian senior school of the textbook meet the global status, will answer by concept of five senses proposed by Smith and by Rehm's. And then this is data analysis procedure: identify and collect the intercultural pragmatic components, compare the quantity of information, and then examine for information about intercultural pragmatic information, and then compile the speech act and conversation from the three EFL textbooks. And then data analysis procedure, this one, as I told you before, that I will use some frameworks that is proposed by the expert. Okay, and then this is my summary of the research. Research question, there are two research questions concerned with intercultural pragmatic component EFL textbooks, and then the EFL textbook status for global English textbook. And then data source, speech act and conversation, data analysis, this one, data analysis, and as my research product, I hope I can reach this space that I can propose or make an alternative to create, maybe for preliminary product, an outline or draft, an EFL textbook draft using intercultural pragmatic approach. This is the instrument for getting data, I will have some tabulation or quantification, speech act, how many speech act in textbook 1, 2, 3, and then metapragmatic information, and then frequency of distribution, I modify from some previous research, and then metapragmatic information by textbook type, coverage of context and speaker relationship, and then number of speech act, illustration of explicit versus implicit pragmatic content from textbook, and then conversational analysis of social contextual factors. Because I see in EFL textbook, the communication is in Indonesia, but the figure is from another culture, the picture or the photograph. Yeah. So it is not something appropriate in my opinion. This is called communicative language teaching. Actually, there are many items, but I only choose and modify from the content, language. It is from the aspect of form, function, discourse, and sociolinguistic content. This is my unit analysis, Erlangga and Bumi Aksara. And then this is a sample of conversation. We can see here. Sometimes the picture, actually in Indonesia, but the picture is from another country. Yeah. And then also there is no background or maybe social relationship between who and whom, the speaker and the interlocutor, and pragmatic metapragmatic information. Thank you for the time, Prof. Stiono, and then I really need your feedback from everyone, from the examiner, for my better draft proposal. Thank you. Thank you, Prof. Yeah. Okay. Okay, thank you, Prof. Didi, for the question. Actually, pragmatic is very interesting for me. It has a branch of linguistic, and pragmatic, as we know, it is the study of speaker meanings in more contextual situation. The same word will have a different effect to the between the speaker and hearer. And then many English teachers, they forget about this aspect. Sentence is only alone. I mean, sentence stands alone without any contextual factors. And then in my teaching experience, when I interview the graduation from senior high school, even to respond greetings or to say something, they have very limited expression. There is no filler, there is, the contextual situation is very limited. And when I refer to EFL textbooks, this happens as well. Many EFL textbooks, they rely only genre based, and I wonder, is it true that senior high school student, they only learn about genre based without any focused communication between themselves with global communication? And then there is also controversy between the needs for inclusion of pragmatics in language teaching. Should we teach pragmatic implicitly, or teacher teach it explicitly? There is still controversy. But in my opinion, I think because English is a foreign language in Indonesia, I do believe that pragmatics should be taught explicitly. How to greet in Indonesian context, how to greet in maybe in what in Europe or Western countries, it will be different. How silent has different meanings. Yeah. This is what I learned about silence. How active silence has different meaning. How Indonesian culture, are they open or maybe closed in their culture? So Prof. Didi, I do hope that by taking this about pragmatics, I can make alternative EFL textbook. Of course, this is a very something challenging for me, and then I should read many references, and then I should be able to compare between Indonesian context, local context, and global context. Maybe okay. Thank you, Prof. Didi. Genre-based approach, the student, they should recognize type of text. Yeah. And this happens from junior high school until senior high school. Narrative text, descriptive text, argumentative, and then recon text. But once again, it is really limited in only written form. The textbooks, separate, or they do not include a pragmatic components, and even the social function also limited to entertain, to describe, to narrate, to retell story, and then to say something in procedure one and so on. So in my opinion, that maybe it is the time for English for the curriculum to be to have more wider aspect of communicative competence. And then communicative competence is the final step of intercultural pragmatic competence. So this is two different things: communicative competence and intercultural pragmatic competence. Intercultural pragmatic competence, as I told you before, that it has strategic competence, it has actional competence, and sociolinguistic competence. Prof. Didi. Yes, text is a compilation of words or letters from the beginning until the most complicated one, paragraph, and then the last one is discourse. And yeah, can be a text oral. Yeah, actually it should be. Yeah, it should be spoken. Yeah, it should be spoken. Okay, and then okay, and sometimes the students they only recite the text without any considering the prosody, without considering what intonation, and then it is very sometimes challenging. Complete a chapter, yeah, in book chapter. Book chapter presents introduction and introduction and then the content and closing. Yeah. Okay. The introduction they start from a previous study or the foundation of previous knowledge. So it okay. Yeah. I'm seeing the books for chapter one. For example, in chapter one, for example, what do you recommend? It is the first introduction is match the following statements with the picture. Okay, and then the second, listen to the dialogue and complete the missing expressions. And then present your discussion result in front of the class. And then complete the following sentences with the words in previous activity. And then ways to say it. It is about recommendation. The last section is about the summary. The assignment is a self-reflection. It is create a dialogue based on the following situations. Cyril is calling Jenny, his secretary, to tell her that the general manager from the main office, Mr. Yahya Situmorang, is coming next week. They are planning how to treat Mr. Situmorang well so that will he not be disappointed with their service. Cyril is asking Jenny for her suggestion about the hotel, the restaurant for the dinner, and some souvenirs they will give. It is the instruction, Prof. Okay, I haven't read for the teacher book or introduction or manual. Okay, bro. Okay. 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 Yeah. 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 Yeah, Prof. Didi. Yeah. 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 Sana. Okay. 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 Oke, okay, Prof. Oke. Oke, Prof. Oke. Ya. Oke, Prof. Thank you. Thank you, Prof. Ya, Prof. Oke, Prof. Oke, Prof. Thank you. Ya, Bu. Thank you. Okay. Okay. Ya. 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 Ya, ya, ibu, ya ibu. Ya. Oke, okay, thank you Ibu Lucy. This is very crucial question because I should find the gaps and I hope I can meet the question. Oke, okay, based on my preliminary reading from some previous research or study, what the previous study they do not relate with the curriculum, Ibu. So they only focus on textbook evaluation, and then speech act and conversation, and the content, but they do not relate to the curriculum. So this is the gap, Ibu. This is the gap. So I do hope that I can make a contribution to the nah, maybe revision or what, yeah? Revision that intercultural pragmatic component should be explicitly included into the curriculum. So the instruction of EFL textbook, they should constitute explicit instruction of pragmatics. When the textbook deals with greeting, for example, the meta pragmatic information should be what? Should be completed or full. Because of course, in Indonesian context, for example, when a Muslim, for example, there is a greeting salam, and maybe in the Christian also has the same greeting. So actually, the textbook should what? Should present this kind of a really real different intercultural pragmatics. As I told you before, that the same greeting, what the same pragma linguistic components, but will have the different socio pragmatic effect, Ibu. For example, in Bahasa Indonesia, selamat malam. Selamat malam, we can say it for when we meet someone and when we want to leave someone. But in English context, when we meet someone, we say good evening, not good night. Because when we say meet someone saying good night, yeah, it is something improper. So my gap is, once again, I would like to maybe relate and then evaluate and make contribution that intercultural pragmatics components should be included explicitly to the curriculum or the EFL textbook. And then I see that in the core competence KI or KD, the context only between peers and teachers. There is no wider communication how to greet with different culture. And then when I see the conversation context, sometimes the picture and maybe the metapragmatic information is still little. So the learners will have will be confused. What should be completed or what should be respond for the fill in the gap, for example. So it is, Ibu. So my gap, that there is gap between English curriculum with the current needs, it is intercultural pragmatic issues, and then the Ministry of Education in his introduction that English learning should be designed to face 21st learning models, but in reality the content of curriculum, once again, still, of course, I do not blame with genre based or grammar based, but maybe we can develop the previous step of genre based or grammar based to intercultural pragmatic competence or approach. And I do hope I can do this one, Ibu. Thank you. Okay, Ibu. Yeah. Okay, Ibu. Yeah. Yeah. Iya, Bu. Oke, Bu. Oke, Bu. Okay. Oke, Bu. Oke, thank you. When you are talking about intercultural what competence, because we deal with English, and then as I crystal explained that English meets the requirements as a lingua franca or a language that used by every country. So the most challenging one is, and I understand what I remember your words, Bu, that we use the language without forgetting our culture. So because the young learners or senior high school students, they will wait context. So we do hope that there is no intercultural pragmatic failures. They should understand how to say this and in what context in global communication. They should understand maybe how the Germany, how the Dutch, how Japanese or how American people to greet or maybe to have leave taking and so on. And they should adapt in institutional context. For example, when they want to talk or chat with foreigner from Australia, for example, they should learn about their culture. Maybe they will think about the words. What words is suitable for the Australian people? And in what context, the social context? So in my opinion, that intercultural pragmatics is the situation that should be coped with an English learners. They can say an expression properly in more understandable global context. And once again, this is not something easy because they should read many kinds of maybe cultural knowledge, and then tradition, and then many things from the culture. And then when I studied last time ago about language and culture, yeah, like silence, yeah. silence also is something with intercultural pragmatic, yeah. In Japanese culture, yeah, when there is marriage, and then the women bride Only silent it means yes. Yeah. But when maybe we go to another country, silent will have different meaning. Maybe it can be it will be offended situation. So once again, EFL textbook, they should include more cultural awareness. Maybe, yeah, maybe 20% maybe from the content, not only instruction or genre-based instruction, but also about the cultural awareness. And then maybe DCT, yeah, discourse completion test, maybe also can make us an instrument, yeah, instrument for EFL textbook to have a free illustration how Indonesian people react to the situational presented in the EFL textbook. That's one ibu from me. I hope there is a clear information for me about intercultural pragmatics. Iya ibu, textbook. It is minor issue in curriculum. Will be major data. Oke, Bu. Oke, Bu. Ya, Ibu. Thank you, Ibu. Thank you. Very valuable comments. Oke, Prof. Oke, okay, Prof. Okay. Ya. 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 Ya, ya. 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 Oke. 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 Oke, okay, Prof. Thank you. Visual. Ya. Word. Ya. Visual ya. Ya. Ya, ya. 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 Ya, not only about text. Ya. So it should be wider, ya. 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 Oke. Okay. Ya. Yeah. Ya. Yeah. Ya, ya, Prof. Oke. 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 Oke, Prof. Oke. Okay. Ya. Yeah. daya kernik. Ya, wis berika ya. Itu selaik milestone ya, Prof ya. Itu selaik milestone of intercultural pragmatics ya. Oke. Oke, bro. Oke, bro. Oke. Oke, Prof. Ya, Prof. Dapat kristal ya, kristal. So criticism, the lack of criticism, Prof ya. Ya. Oke, Prof. Thank you, Prof. Oke, Prof. Thank you. So I should make my own mainstream, Prof. I should make my own mainstream. Ya, Prof. Oke, Prof. Oke, Prof. Oke, thank you, Prof. Okay, Prof, thank you. Iya, Pak. Iya, Pak Yasir. Oke, okay, thank you, Pak Yasir. Of course, I will not only criticize or evaluate, but I also I do hope that in my final step, once again I can offer, I can offer or an alternative of EFL textbook using intercultural pragmatic components. It is the product. Maybe it is like maybe guidance or maybe draft EFL textbook using intercultural pragmatics. It is my product, Pak Yasir. Ya. Yeah, SFL ya. Yeah. Oke. Ya, baik. Oke. Oke, Pak ya. Oke, Bro. Oke, thank you, Pak ya sih. Thank you, Prof. Oke. 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 Okay. So I am leaving now, Prof, ya. Yeah? Oke. Okay. Thank you, Prof. Oke, okay, thank you, Prof. Alhamdulillah, ya Rabbil Alamin. Selesai sesi kedua berkaitan dengan question and answer tentang proposal disertasi saya yang berkaitan dengan the representation of intercultural pragmatic aspect or components in 3EFL Indonesian textbooks. Mudah-mudahan konstruksi atau masukan-masukan tadi yang disampaikan oleh penguji bisa memberikan manfaat. Dan banyak hal yang harus saya perbaiki di sini, di mana saya harus memberikan beberapa penelitian sebelumnya atau knowledge sebelumnya yang berkaitan dengan intercultural pragmatics. Kemudian tadi juga disampaikan bahwa karena saya akan mengkritisi berkaitan dengan konten buku bahasa Inggris yang memang lebih cenderung banyak genre based, saya harus bisa untuk setidaknya menguasai dulu berkaitan dengan apa itu genre based, istilahnya sampai dengan state of the art-nya lah, kemudian saya nanti bisa mengkritisi dan memberikan alternatif berkaitan dengan produk penelitian tentang intercultural pragmatic. Kemudian juga tadi disampaikan bahwa saya harus lebih fokus berkaitan dengan dua isu besar. Pertama, intercultural pragmatic dalam EFL textbook dan tentang sejauh mana penggunaan EFL textbook ini dalam konteks global. Dalam konteks global. Ini akan menjadi salah satu yang cukup menarik. Kemudian juga di introduction tadi disampaikan harus lebih konstruktif dan tidak messy begitu. Dan dipahami karena memang menulis bagian dari proses seperti itu. Kemudian diharapkan juga bahwa ya teori-teori systemic functional linguistic atau SFL juga harus saya kaji kembali. berkaitan dengan tadi, karena memang kurikulum bahasa Inggris yang sekarang itu tentu roots-nya adalah genre based dan SFL tadi, sehingga harus bisa betul-betul dimaksimalkan. Kemudian juga harus bisa berkaitan dengan diachronic intercultural pragmatics, jadi harus membaca berkaitan dengan sejauh mana development atau perkembangan dari pragmatik, dan kemudian juga hingga saat ini berkaitan dengan intercultural pragmatics. Luar biasa, masukan-masukannya sangat berharga, dan mudah-mudahan bisa dikoreksi dan diperbaiki di sesi berikutnya. Dan saat ini saya sedang menunggu hasil dari penguji. Mudah-mudahan mendapatkan hasil yang optimal seperti itu. siap-siap gimana, gimana apa aja lama-lama. Bentang, maaf kucing bentang. Kucing maaf, tutupin pintu, tutupin pintu. Oke, Prof, I'm here. I feel released, Prof. Alhamdulillah, thank you, Prof. Oke, 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 Prof. Thank you. Oke, Prof. Thank you. Oke, Prof. Oke, I would like to say thank you very much to all the examiner, to promoter and co-promoter, and to the department. I hope I can follow up better and sooner for this session because I have limited time. About 6 months, 6 months in the future, so I should finish soon. And then once again, maybe I need what I will consult more anything, maybe in the group because there is a WhatsApp group between me and Prof. Bahrain and Pak Yasir, so I'd be more active in questioning anything. Thank you for the feedback, Prof. Thank you, Prof. Didi. Thank you, Prof. Ya, Pak Yasir. Not yet, not yet. I will look for it. Yeah. Yeah, yeah. I will look for it for my reference also. Yeah. Okay. Okay, bro. Okay, Pak Yasir. I will look at it. Okay. Ya, baik. Thank you, Pak Yasir. Oke. Oke, Pak Yasir. Halo. Oke. Oke, Pak. Thank you. Thank you. Amin. Thank you, Prof. Prof Baren. Yeah. Thank you, Prof. Ibu Lucy, thank you, Prof Baren, Pak Perpidi, Pak Cecep, thank you. Iya, Bu. Insya Allah, Bu. Amin. Amin. Ya. Siap. Oke, Bu. Oke. Oke. Thank you, Bu. Ya. Yeah. Oke. Okay. Ya, yeah. Ya, yeah, Bu. Thank you, Bu. Oke. Okay. Oke, Bu. Oke, Bu. Oke. Okay. Oke. Okay. Oke, okay, Bu. Thank you, Ibu Lucy. Oke. Okay. Oke. Oke. Okay. Oke, okay, Bu. Thank you, Bu. Oke, okay, Bu. Thank you. Thank you. I will approve it. Salah. Oke, okay, Pak. Siap. I will to the publisher. Oke. Okay. Oke, okay, thank you Prof Dede, Bu Lucy, Prof Sti, ya, yeah, Pak Yasir, Prof Baren. Ya, yeah, I'm leaving. Oke. Okay. Amin. Thank you, Prof Dede. Ya, yeah, I'm leaving. Mohon.